I cannot tell you how thankful I am that I am permitted to have this life, to be allowed to have a life in art, to be allowed to live in this wonderful city, to be allowed to express myself, and fortunately have people seem to appreciate what it is that I do and have made a living possible for me. I mean, this is a great, great gift. I was born in Cleveland, Ohio, in the middle of the Slovenian community there, which, as it turns out over the years, I've discovered has informed my aesthetic life, a kind of Eastern European depth of feeling. At a very early age, my grandmother, after the death of my grandfather, moved out to the country, 35 miles to the east of Cleveland, into a community called Painesville. Actually, it was in the township outside of Painesville. She had a general store, and the general store was, essentially in the middle of nowhere, except all around my grandmother's general store were nursery fields. And these were flowering plants and trees that were being raised to ship, various places around the United States. And I don't know, from the earliest times, I remember being drawn to them. And anytime I had my paint box or an opportunity, I would be painting these flowers and plants and so forth. It seemed like the most natural possible thing for me to do, since that's what was around. Painting flowers, especially painting something that's already intrinsically beautiful, seems to, in many cases, demean the art so that it seems as though you're not really saying anything. So when I came to San Francisco, I thought, well, I won't paint flowers anymore. We'll leave that behind me, and I'll do something far more meaningful and paint landscapes. So I don't know why. Landscapes seem to be all right. Flowers don't seem to be all right. Anyway, I was happily painting my landscapes away, and I had found my way through friends into a gallery here in San Francisco, when one day the gallery owner called and said, Gary, could you please come down? There's something I want to talk to you about. And I thought, oh dear, this is the end of it. You know, my good time as having a life in art, such as it was, is soon to be over. Well, what happened was I went to his office and he said, you know, Gary, I look at your paintings and they're fine. We don't have any problems with that. However, somehow I keep thinking you should be painting flowers. All of my work is done from life. So I get the plants from the San Francisco Flower Mart and bring them back here to the studio. And without too much arranging I don't want it to be tricky. I want it to be natural. Always historically, I had admired the draftsmanship of Ang and how he could make these superb portraits of people using only a single line. There was no question as to if it was to the right or the left. He only drew exactly the correct line. It looks so simple and it's so difficult. So over the years, I am not Ang by any stretch of the imagination, but over the years I have learned to draw using a very sharp pencil and drawing just a single line and keeping things in proportion and having it all be an accurate portrayal of what it is that's in my mind.
How I personally feel about Gary's work is I find it to be very contemporary. It has a classic, you know, there's a classic style there with, you know, these meticulous flowers and beautifully executed. But I find that, you know, all the negative space and the really strong, almost abstract compositions, I think make them very, very contemporary and very, I think, very much in current in the time, in the art market right now. I think people are looking for this kind of work, and it has a wide appeal.
I went to the American Academy in Rome, and that was the beginning of this big change in my life. When I went there, everything was very still and staid, and by the time I left it, already just a tiny bit had begun to release, and things were getting a little looser. And over the course of the past 5 years, they've gone crazy, you know. Yeah. Everything has become unbound and flying through the air with joy and
hopefully
energy.
Yes, you can see still life here.
Yes.
It really, I mean, the asparagus are flying, the strawberries are
jumping
off the plate.
Well, they're flying and I'm flying.
Yeah, so it's really, it's just amazing how much you've changed and developed over these years.
But isn't change is the thing an artist, I think, looks for? I mean, I'm sure you hear this from all the artists that you represent. Before it ever makes it to the final painting, into all the heart goes into the little sketch. So my works, they start with only an idea, and I bring the materials into the studio and I start to make a composition, and I only know initially the very beginnings of a painting. And so I draw those things that I've already imagined. And then after I've done that, then I'll look at it and the painting will begin to tell me how it's going to evolve. And so it kind of grows organically out of itself.
And your style, I mean, do you feel like it's over the years you've gotten better and better as a painter?
There's no doubt about it.
Your incredible watercolors and your technique is flawless already.
Well, you get to be old enough and you get to be flawless, at least as far as technique goes.
Yeah.
Technique is practice.
Right.
And the whole idea, I think, when you start out is, one is unaware that you need to study more what it is that you're doing. But as time passes and the repetition of painting after painting after painting, the facility becomes greater and easier. The connection between the brain and the things that you can think of and the paintings you see in your mind actually start to become reality as the hand is able to do what it is that the brain desires.
Right.
Many years ago, Bob Johnson at our museum here had said to me, well, you know, one of the nice things about your paintings, Gary, is that when you're finished with them, there's still room for the viewer. Yeah. And I didn't quite understand what he meant by that remark until as the years passed, and of course as I'm making paintings, I begin them and I finish them and I think that that's it.
Right.
When I'm done, they're done. And I discovered, no, in truth, that's the day they begin to live, as I would hear what people tell me they see in my work. And I think, oh my goodness, they see all that in there?
Yeah.
It's wonderful when the viewer can project himself into a work of art.